This is time that we discuss Nayantara Sahgal, a living Indian writer in English. And she is a noted social activist also. And she belonged to the Nehru-Gandhi family. And her mother was Nehru's sister, Vijayalakshmi Pandit. Nayantara Sahgal was the daughter of Vijayalakshmi Pandit. And Sahgal became a writer of novels. And her first novel was A Time to be Happy, and it appeared in 1957. And her latest novel, Lesser Breeds, appeared in 2003. And now she is 94 years old. And she is a living Indian writer, Nayantara Sahgal, the daughter of Vijayalakshmi Pandit. And Vijayalakshmi Pandit was actually the sister of Jawaharlal Nehru. And in that way, Nayantara Sahgal is related to Indira Gandhi, and both are cousins. And they were always enmetical also, kept a rivalry. There was rivalry between Indira Gandhi and Nayantara Sahgal. And Sahgal came out with her first novel in 1957. It was entitled A Time to be Happy. And in 2003, her latest novel, Lesser Breeds, appeared. And very recently, in 2019, she came out with a novel, not a long novel, but a novel entitled The Fate of Butterflies. So that appeared in 2019. And still she had been writing literature, even though she is aged 94. And she received the Sahitya Academy Award for her novel, Rich Like Us. And in the case of Nayantara Sahgal also, she retained her Academy Award because of the Sahitya Academy's perceived inaction on the murder of M.M. Kalaburgi, Govind Bansari and Narendra Dabulkar. And Sahgal, Sachidanandan and P.K. Parakadovu. P.K. Parakadovu and Sachidanandan were the members of Sahitya Academy. And Sachidanandan was actually the chairman of the Sahitya Academy. And all these people retained their honorary degrees and memberships due to the Academy's perceived inaction on the murder of social activists and writers like M.M. Kalaburgi, Govind Bansari and Narendra Dabulkar. Sahgal was also a social activist and she retained the Sahitya Academy Awards due to the inaction of the Sahitya Academy to condemn the murder of Kalaburgi, Bansari and Dabulkar. And we discussed the novel Rich Like Us, and it is this novel that won her the Sahitya Academy Award. And the award was given to her in 1985. And the title, interestingly, Rich Like Us, and it is actually taken from a dialogue presented in the novel. It is from a dialogue presented in the novel we come to find the term Rich Like Us. And actually it deals with the story of two women. Rich Like Us deals with the story of two women during the emergency declared by Indira Gandhi. And Indira Gandhi is referred to in the novel as Madam. And I told you, Sahgal was a cousin of Indira Gandhi and both were rivals also. And Indira Gandhi declared emergency in 1975 and The emergency continued for 2 years, 1977, and so emergency seemed to be a darkened part of the India's history, and many social activists were imprisoned, including Jayaprakash Narayan, and the people were not permitted to speak, so the people were asked to hold their tongue and to work. And emergency actually marked a black episode in the history of India. And in the novel Rich Like Us, we come to find two female living and facing the adversities during the emergency. And the female protagonists are Rosie and Sonali. One female protagonist is Rosie, and the other is Sonali. Rose or Rosie? Rose, a British immigrant. Actually, she came from Britain. And she got married with a businessman named Ram. Ram was actually a married man. And Ram met Rose in a sweet shop in London. And she became interested in Ram. And when Ram told her about India, Rose actually wanted to come and live in India. And she got married with Ram and came to India. But Ram was actually a married man. Even when Rose learned that Ram was a married man, she got married with him. She liked India and wanted to learn about India. Therefore, she came to India and started to live with the businessman, Mr. Ram. And Rose, actually his second wife. And they met in England at a sweet shop and suddenly fell in love. And Rose got married with the middle-aged Ram, even after knowing that Ram was already a married man. And Ram had a son named Dev. And so Dev was a bad, spoilt young man. A bad and spoilt man. And he used to create a lot of problems also in the family. And the first wife of Ram was named Mona. And Dev was the son of Ram and Mona. And when Ram's health started to deteriorate, when Ram became old and his health started to deteriorate, the erring son Dev, the spoilt young man Dev, placed a whip hand on him. And he manipulated the signature of his father and took money from the bank and started to control the business of Ram. And he had even sold the furniture in the house where Rose was staying. And Rose was staying in another house, and he started selling the furniture of the house when the father was so physically incapable of doing anything. When his health started deteriorating, the son put a whip hand on him and made him sign the checks. And in some occasions, he manipulated the signature of his father and took money from the bank and started selling the property of Ram also, including the furniture in the house where Rose was staying. And there was no one for Rose to tend to. There was no one to help Rose, except the civil servant Sonali. And I told you there are two female protagonists in the novel. One is Rose or Rosie, and the other is Sonali, an IAS officer. And she is found working under government, and she is a very faithful and honest officer, Sonali. And she was a very courageous officer. And she always maintained a just stand in all the matters that came to her. She was very just in her dealings. And she had a best friend named Devi Kuchru. And they were together while studying at the Oxford University. Sonali and Devi Kuchru were there together. And he also became a civil servant, Devi Kuchru. And Devi Kuchru always spoke of injustice on the side of the government towards the poor people. In the beginning, he seemed to be a socialist in his approach. And in his speech, he appeared a revolutionary. But when emergency was declared, Devi Kuchru continued to work without any protest. He adjusted with the situation. And it was at the time Dev placed a new proposal for a factory to Sonali. So he placed a proposal for a factory to produce a fizzy drink, a soft drink, and it was called Happyola. So he actually wanted to produce a soft drink called Happyola, and for that, so large amount of water was required. And it would tend to become an exploitation of water if he would be given the permission to start the soft drink company. And they had a partner also named Newman. And he was a foreigner, and both planned to start the fizzy drink company called Happyola. And they placed a proposal before Sonali, and Sonali examined the proposal and wrote a note of refusal. She maintained that if such a factory would be started, it would exploit water of the area, so it would create a scarcity of water, that the villagers would be in great difficulty of getting water if the project was given permission. So she produced a refusal note on the project, and they came into conflict. Dev and Sonali came into a conflict. And it was at the time Rose was staying in the house with limited furniture, because the furniture sold by Dev, and Dev was not providing her sufficient money for her day-to-day activities. And she was not provided with the provisions, and she had to face a lot of adversities in the house. And on a day, her dead body was found in the well. Rose's dead body was found in the well. And it was not sure whether she was murdered or whether she committed suicide anyhow. So she became dead. Her dead body was found in the well. And in the case of the next protagonist, Sonali, she was a justice officer. And she refused the proposal of Dev, because the proposal of Dev was a kind of exploitation of water, and she stood against it. And what actually happened was that Sonali was transferred. From her department, she was transferred to a petty post under state government. In the beginning, she was found working under central government. But due to her adamant stance and just actions, she was not honored, but she was transferred to a petty post under state government. And in this novel, we come to find the exploitation of the upper class, the industrialists and the capitalists, and the government supporting the capitalists for doing the exploitation. And this novel won her a Sahitya Academy Award in 1985. But she retained the Sahitya Academy Award, I told you, because of the presumed inactivity of the Sahitya Academy in condemning the murder of Pansari, Kalaburgi, and Dabulkar, Narendra Dabulkar. And Sasi Deshpande also retained her Sahitya Academy Award to the Academy. And these all are the things that we have to remember from Nayantara Sahgal and from her novel, Rich Like Us. Thank you.